Hello. So today we have a nice laptop. It's a 1.4 inch wide. It's a Dell Latitude E6430. It's a Latitude series, and it's a really nice laptop with metallic cover and some awesome laptop in terms of quality and fiability. So don't have RAM, don't have hard drive, needs cleaning and so on. So first need to take out the battery. Missing screw. First we have two screw here, only have one. This is a hard drive cover, and we have here rubber for maintain HDD isolated from shocks. And then we have you see, and then we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 screw, but we only have one. Okay, now this cover comes like that. Okay, and to the front. Okay, it has some special clamps. Okay, and then we take like that. Okay, so okay, no RAM. We have some dust. Very much dust. I think someone clean before. Okay, here optical. Yeah, so this is from March 2013, and it's a DVD-ROM. Okay, not DVD writer. We replace that with an DVD driver. Now we check battery BIOS, because this notebook have enough years, maybe 8, 9, 10 years, and it have 1.2 volts. Okay, this also needs to be changed. And I think this is the CPU, okay, this is chipset, and I think we have a dedicated video. The previous customer says that laptop working. Okay, we have two screw, black one for video pay attention not to replace with the CPU one. CPU one have white nickel plate, and I think they are not the same. Okay, Okay, so you need to jiggle a bit. Never use screwdriver to force lift up. Okay, come on. So we need to up in this direction and then in this direction. Okay, yeah, it's an Nvidia chip, and we have some very bad situation. Chipset don't have a thermal pad. Phew, that's a bad thing. Okay, isopropylic alcohol. Clean and clean the old thermal paste. The chip is very clean. Okay, you see Nvidia. I take out the CPU and clean the inside socket because dust going to every hole. So this is CR0MZ. Let me check. The customer said, previous owner said that this is was E5. CR0MZ. So this is E5 3000 210M at 2.5 gigahertz. Okay, that's a nice CPU in combination with an SSD. This laptop is very nice to work. Okay, so because it's an old laptop, re-screwed all the screw because they are loose, some of them. Okay. I think this is the original thermal paste. I think. We leave the pad from video memory here because they are in very good shape. Thank you.
And as always, we need to check the fins of the radiator, because all the dust stays in there. Okay, so very too not no dust. That's a nice. Okay. I always clean the fins of the radiator with alcohol, because isopropylic alcohol, because they need to be very clean to dust come out. At the chipset, I don't know what I need here. Thermal pad or paste, and we do check and see. Practical check here. The screw doesn't want to go inside the hole. Okay, now it's good. Always keep the screwdriver perfect perpendicular to the screw, not in some angle. Okay, perfect. So how we check if here we have we need a thermal pad or thermal paste? We check very simple. We put a tiny amount of thermal paste, and we put the radiator in place. We press on the CPU here at the middle, and take out. And if the thermal paste is spreading very nicely at all surface of the chip, we need thermal paste. If, as you see in this case, if the thermal paste was not spreading, that means we need thermal pad in there. Okay, So I think I have some some thermal pad which I saved from another laptop. No need to take out the thermal paste also. It's a very tiny amount. And then we do another check. So we have like this. We press. Take out. So then is good, but is not very good. That pad is 0.5 millimeter. So we need 1 millimeter pad. And in 1 millimeter I have a big one, so I need to cut it in clean with some water. Okay. We leave it a big size. Because there are no disadvantage of that. And we do final testing. We have some paste here. They are not spread all over. And we press, take out. And then it's not all over because not was not very very much amount of thermal paste, but now it's good. Because it's all spread almost all thermal paste is spread. So we leave it like that. Some chipset do need 0.5 thermal paste, but most of them need 1 millimeter pad. Okay. Okay. We are good to go. Thank you. So the nickel one at the CPU and the black one at the video card, video chip. We screw just a few rotation and then we screw to the end. Okay. Okay. Memory RAM. This laptop, it's a normal CPU. It uses only normal normal DIM, not with low. It's PC free, okay? Not PC free L. PC free simple. So here you have 4 GB. And we put another 4. Okay, so I'm gonna put 4 plus 2 GB. Okay. That's it. Then battery BIOS. I use a second one. It has a 3.219 volts, which is very nice. We have to take out this plastic. Okay. This is going to recycle bin, and in the end it will go on IKEA. Okay, then we have this. Okay, red 4 plus. And black 4 minus. Okay, the 1, 2. To make the joints, I cut it with some metal part from the original soldering, but now it has to be good. Okay. Okay, so this is the plus. And this is the minus. Okay. Let's check. So minus on black. Okay, it's good. We have to put the battery on the shrinking rubber. That's okay. Okay. I keep it like that to remain in that position. So that's very nice. Okay, that's very nice. Let's hope because wire are shorter. Let's hope it's enough. They are enough. Okay, they are not enough. They are shorter, but. Because here we don't mount cellular or Bluetooth card, we put it here and leave it like that. We need to use some double adhesive. Securing position, and that's it. Okay. Goes on here. Okay. Okay, now optical drive. It's a slim version, 9mm. First we need to take out this cartridge. Okay. And then we have two screws in here. Okay. All three screws, they are the same. So we have here a DVD drive. Which I tested a week ago. Also SATA drive. And this is a multi-DVD writer from LG. And this is manufactured on September 2014, okay? So it's a little bit newer than this. Okay. So, we have a problem. Not very much, but we have a problem. You see? Original have two holes, this one have just one, but it's enough because this laptop come with this cartridge device because they are designated to take down the optical drive and put in place the second battery, but at this laptop customer will not use the second battery, never. Okay. When I press it, okay, because here don't have a screw, you see, it's going in lateral, but this is not a problem because in the laptop don't have room to slide. So we produce one screw. With some very thin needle, we take out the tray from drive, so my process to change the face of the degrader is first take out the big clamps and then slide it in that direction. So I have to press okay, and then okay, and now jiggle bit, and that's it. Perfect. Also, at recycle metal bin. On this hole, okay. So
here and here, and then this notebook don't have this plastic here. We need to use hot glue. Okay, now it's good. But I want to put some hot glue in here because it's not very, very, very secure in position. Okay, we wait to get warmer the hot gun, hot glue gun. Okay, so I glue the plastic here, and I think I put too much hot glue, and I cut it just a tiny piece. Okay, let's see. Yeah, it's good. Okay, it's good. Okay, this open, put it in the position. And then close. Okay, that's it. Maybe I because it's not gonna be use a battery in here, I put the screw here to block the exit the DVD writer. Don't need to take it out anymore. Okay, double check. Okay. That's it. And I use 128 gigabyte SSD. It's a OEM part. They are very reliable and very nice at speed. So in this position, and we need a screw in here. And I don't know. I don't understand how this works. Okay, so we put the rubber with holes in here,
and then like that. Let's find a screw, a short screw. I think this is the one. No. I need a one with with the part with a big one. Okay, so this is nice. And I don't know the order. Okay, okay. Let's put this one. First, we check this base, and then press. Okay, and then this one. Yeah. Okay. Perfect. Okay, no screw. Because we already have a very amount of screw, but we have in here, in this. Okay. Was better that always make a test before you put all screw and all the covers. And I think this is the tiny screw. No, maybe longer. I think here we have no. Here we have tiny screw and long, okay, not the regular one, okay. Let's see. Yeah, I was right, and I have to find another one, and I found it. Okay, perfect. Let's check. Okay, I didn't screw this. I do it now. Okay. Let's see. Power on, power off, because battery BIOS was take out. Second power on. And we have picture. Okay, E5-3000, 6 GB of RAM. Battery health low. Okay, and we see the SSD. No, we don't see. Let me put like this. We don't see the SSD. Let's see why. Okay, load default. Okay, and let's set it up together. Okay, no hard drive. Audio okay, wireless okay. We have a bigger resolution on display because we have NVIDIA chip. Okay, okay, so let's set it up the date. Okay. Integrated mic only enabled, parallel, serial, SATA, RAID 1. Okay, we don't want RAID 1, we want ACHI. Drives all for SATA, no smart. Okay. Next video Optimus. Okay. Curbo disable. Multicore all, space step, C state, turbo boost, hyper threading enabled. Okay. Wake on LAN disabled. Adaptive. Adapter okay, it has to be adapter, it has to be enabled because we want to know if we have problem with charger. Virtualization okay, switch okay. Okay, yeah. Clear log. Clear log. Apply and exit. Let's see now if he sees the SSD.
maybe in some cases, because SSD are smaller in size than old hard drive, and because I mounted in this position, it happened me not once but many more. The problem is that SSD, you see, here is okay, here is space. SSD is going like this one, and the main board is here, okay? And I put it like this one, not like this. So put it like this, okay. So let's check before we put the screw. And I was right, okay. Now it says 128 gigabyte HDD, whatever it says, it's an SSD. So that's it for now. I have to clean this label, this one and this one, and then install Windows, and that's it. I will I will stop the video, but I have to clean this. Okay. So I screw this the screw here, and now in the display. Keyboard. Pay attention that you put cleaning solution on the sponge and not directly on the keyboard, because we don't want to liquid to get into the keyboard. Board looks very nice now.
awesome. And now
we want to take out those label, and I use hot air, not very hot. This notebook belongs to a firm that renew all the notebook. Okay. Just a tiny sign remaining. Okay. Focus. But this is looking very nice now. And then have this one. This is very hard to take out, but because this is metal, and hot air is spreading fast. Okay. Okay. And now we use kind of. Let's see, isopropylic alcohol. Came out very nice. No glue. Very nice. And here we have a big one. Writing something here. We have to warm up the whole cover. Yeah, very nice. Very nice. Very nice. Phew. I was lucky. No, I have to warm up in advance. Very nice. Okay, we only have a tiny piece of adhesive remaining. Very nice, very, very nice. Phew. Very nice quality. You see? Very nice. Okay. So, that's it, guys. Thanks a lot. Bye.